Paul and Heather both had diarrhea. Paul the sociologist drank water to stave off dehydration. Heather the biologist drank water mixed with sugar and salt. Paul clearly does not remember the concept of memory transport from his biology course and is now suffering from the consequences of not paying attention in class. Don't be a Paul. Membrane transport refers to the movement of solutes across the plasma membrane. The plasma membrane is often thought of as a gatekeeper, where the movement of solutes into and out of a cell is regulated. Some solutes, such as oxygen and carbon dioxide, pass through the membrane very easily. But other solutes, such as sugars, require specialized membrane proteins. In other words, the plasma membrane is selectively permeable. Much like a fishing net allows water to pass through, but not the fish. The reason Heather's drink was effective in stopping her diarrhea rests in the mechanism of membrane transport. It's not just the digestive system, however, that uses membrane transport. In fact, all organ systems use membrane transport to maintain homeostasis. Examples include removal of cellular waste, firing of neurons, export of proteins, maintenance of extracellular fluid, and cell communication. In this module, we will explore the function of the plasma membrane, how the chemical structure of the membrane allows it to be selectively permeable, the mechanisms for the various types of membrane transport, and what determines the direction of solute movement.